In this video, we will see how to build the hardware configuration for an H7300 main rack. Here is the main rack consisting of a 5 amp power supply, 315 Profinet CPU, 32-bit digital input module, 16-bit digital output module, and 18 8-out digital module, and a 2-channel analog input module. We will need the order numbers of the modules, and you can learn more about this in the previous video. We will use this chart with model number and order number to help us in our project. Right click on new project, insert a new object, schematic 300 station. You may rename the station if you like. Let's call this one my_station. Double click on my station, then double click on the hardware icon. Drop down the schematic 300 list, drop down rack 300. And double click to insert a rail. Resize the window as necessary. Drop down PS300. Highlight the first 5 amp power supply and check the order number in the lower right box. Looks like this is the one. Then double click it to add to the rack. Drop down CPU 300. Drop down CPU 315-2PNDP and double click the version number. The Ethernet dialog box opens. We will change its IP address to 192.168.111.102 to match the network the CPU will be used on. Click OK. Slot 3 is reserved for a special interface module which is used to communicate to one main rack to a second main rack. It's not compulsory to use anymore because Profibus is typically used. So we move the highlight to slot 4. Drop down DI300. Select the first 32-bit 24-volt module and check the order number. This is the module we are looking for, so double click to add it to the rack. Drop down DO300. Highlight the first 16-bit 24-volt module and check the order number. Continue down the list until you find the correct order number. It looks like this is the one. Double click to add it to the rack. Drop down DIDO300 and search for the correct order number. Double click or drag it to the rack. Drop down AI300 and search for the order number. Double click to add it to the rack. Click the save and compile button. This compiles the hardware configuration data and save it to the project. This concludes this video. Thanks for watching and subscribe.